sun damage, there's a few things that are sort of more cosmetically apparent, and then there's other changes that we can consider that can lead to precancerous lesions and skin cancer lesions. So just from the common sort of type of changes that we can see brown pigmentation. We can see spots called lentigos, which is usually circular round spots that, again, are common in the face. We can see them on the hands as well. We can see red pigmentation. Often, sometimes we can see it on the side of the neck in folks who've had a lot of sun exposure. We can also see a lot of wrinkles because, again, what happens with the sun exposure over years, the deeper layers of the skin become more atrophied and more thinned out, so that causes a lot of wrinkles. And then, there's some medical conditions that we see as dermatologists that are precancerous. So some of the lesions we see are called actinic keratosis, which are rough red spots, which can potentially progress to other spots, such as squamous cell skin cancers. There's other skin cancers we see, such as basal-cell skin cancers and melanomas. And the scary statistics is that Canada-wide, let's say 1 in 5 or 1 in 6 Canadians will develop a form of a skin cancer in their lifetime. So it's the most common type of cancer is a skin cancer. So sun, there's a lot of dangers to be aware of.